This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree.
In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to a species of tree found both in Indiana and also the North Woods, where Purdue Forestry and Natural Resources annually holds a five-week summer practicum for our forestry and natural resources students. This particular species is found mostly in wetland or saturated soil environments, and it is black ash. Black ash, as I mentioned, typically found in wetland environments. You can see the standing water here. So high water tables, even seasonally standing water, is a common habitat for black ash. Black ash is a little unusual compared to green ash and white ash in that it has very light gray, flaky bark instead of the strong interlaced ridging pattern, often forming diamonds that we see on green and white ash. As in all the ashes, black ash has opposite leaf arrangement and compound leaves. And the leaflets on these compound leaves are typically directly attached to the leaf stem, unlike white ash, which often has a very small little stem on the leaflets themselves. If we look up, we can see black ash is not yet quite producing leaves, where many of the other tree species are. So a little later to leaf out, and you can also see very coarse branching. So pretty heavy branches to hold those larger compound leaves. Black ash has a long tradition of use by native peoples for making baskets because it does what we call ring shake, or separate very easily along the growth rings, producing ideal conditions for the wood to produce basket strips. However, black ash is also under threat from the emerald ash borer, a huge concern both for the natural environment and also for those peoples that use it for a variety of purposes. So black ash, an ash species found both in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan and also in Indiana on wetland habitats.